Hello, this is Matt again with another Maya Quick Tip. Today I want to briefly talk to you about the concept of muscle memory. So, as in anything, once you use Maya long enough, you'll naturally start to develop a subconscious method of doing certain tasks, much like how someone might learn to look left and right before crossing a street, or subconsciously do all the little things that go into a golf swing. Strong muscle memory is usually a great indicator of skill in any craft, but only if what you remember is correct, quick, and efficient. Today I'm going to show you one of the most efficient muscle memories you can train in Maya, not to mention one of the best kept secrets, the marking menus. Now, you're probably asking yourself, marking menus? You mean that right-click thing I use to change component modes or assign materials? What's so special about that? Well, for one, you might not realize it, but there's actually a few different marking menus, including right-click, shift-right-click, control-right-click, and control-shift-right-click, and more. Each of these are thematic. For example, control-right-click is for all your selection conversions. While any of the transform shortcuts plus left-click give you options for those tools. Shift right-click even adapts to what you currently have selected, so it always shows something useful for the moment. For a more comprehensive overview of what each of these menus contains, you can check out my video on hidden menus in Maya. But today, I want to get into another well-kept secret about them, the fact that they're actually gestural. That means you can activate anything in this radial dial simply by swiping with the mouse or tablet stylus, even before the menu comes up. So to use the previous example, I can hold shift and right mouse button with this cylinder selected to display a bunch of useful modeling tools like multicut. Or I can simply shift swipe left with the right mouse button
shift, swipe, left.
To immediately get the multicut tool. With a little practice, you can actually get pretty fast at this. Like, watch how I can make a hole up here by first swiping left with the right mouse button to switch to vertices, selecting the middle vertex, then control swiping down to change the selection to faces, delete them, swipe up for edges, then double click this edge to get the ring, extrude, 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 then control swipe left to convert to vertices, and then shift swipe up to merge them to center. And then, if I just shift extrude these middle faces, I have the start of a car muffler. So not only is that drastically faster and smoother than going through the menus, but it's actually a lot of fun too. You start to feel like a Maya wizard waving your mouse around to cast different spells. And before you think to yourself, there's no way I'd ever remember all those menus, it's important to note that they all follow logical conventions. For example, for anything to do with components, up is always for edges, left is for vertices, down is for faces, and so on. Or for modeling, up is for merging things, while down is for extruding them. With a little practice, these conventions become second nature, much like that golf swing. Don't believe me? Well then let me leave you today with this footage of our good friend Domenico Alessi over at Eidos Studios, building a chair using nothing but marking menu swipes, including nested two-swipe menus.